go.
TV, I've got the wonderful Pippa saying different here, and we're going to have to do the interviews today. So, Arsenal 3-0 win against Wimbledon. What's your thoughts?
Do you know what? First half, I wasn't convinced we'd get a convincing win. I spoke to a lot of AFC Wimbledon fans before the game, and they were giving it. They were like, "We're the highest goal-scoring team in Europe. Scored 22 goals, 20 more than you." And they was like, "Watch out for Ollie Palmer." And they mentioned Nightingale's best centre back. What all this nonsense? And I was thinking, oh. Because of their confidence, I was starting to feel it, like, oh, should we be worried? First half happened, Wimbledon played really well. I don't think the goal line really depicts how well Wimbledon played, because I felt they were really well organised. They were pinging the ball around. Well, you don't agree?
No, I do. Do you think it was Wimbledon played well in the first half then that stifled Arsenal then? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I genuinely thought they were going to keep us at 1-0, but obviously Saka came on second half towards the end and completely changed the game. I honestly believe if he didn't come on, then we would have kept it at 1-0 on just a penalty, which is not good enough for me. I know it's a win, but, you know, just about scoring a goal, scrambling one against Norwich, a free kick against Burnley, and then a penalty against AFC Wimbledon in a Carabao Cup doesn't, you know, it doesn't really make me excited to think we're going to achieve much this season. But we're through to the next round. Leeds next.
So, yeah, Leeds in the next round. But what do you think is wrong with Arsenal? Because I'm watching that game today, I just don't feel that they've going forward. I don't think we've got a plan. Is that what you feel?
Yeah, that's exactly the same. There's no cohesion. Like, what's that word? It's not transitioning to the attacking players. And we sometimes say that when Aubameyang's playing up front, it's going to show that it's not just the players that are up front, because we had Eddie Nketiah, Lacazette and Martinelli up front today, and it still wasn't transitioning through to them. And whenever it did, nothing came of it. There was no completing nothing in the final third, which is very frustrating. That's why I'm saying a 1-0, if it stayed at 1-0 penalty, that shows everything that's wrong with Arsenal right now. There's no seriously attacking football. I said earlier today on Good Morning Arsenal that my favourite attacking formation is when Emile Smith-Rowe links up with Saka and Lacazette, because when them three link up, you're more than likely going to get goals, and that's exactly what we saw.
Yeah. So what do you think of Martinelli's performance and Eddie? I thought they'd done okay without really looking like a goal threat.
Yeah, I mean, I felt like neither of those players had to come out of second or third gear. They did what they needed to do. Really bright moments from Eddie on the left wing, even though he had a good pre-season on the left. But I'm just not used to seeing him there. I want to see him through the middle. But regardless, he beat his player more times than none, got through on goal, got his goal at the end of the day. And like you said, his phone's never disconnected. Comes through on a Nokia brick phone, he said.
No, he done well. From that point of view, do you think, like, because we won 3-0, that masks a few things? They say if it had stayed 1-0, do you think everybody would have been a little bit more unhappier in it? Because the atmosphere, again, was fantastic in here today.
I can't speak for everyone, but if it stayed 1-0, I wouldn't have been happy. Of course, I would have been happy we got through, but I wouldn't have been pleased with that result being just a penalty. But I've got to commend all the fans that came out tonight. There was, I think, 50,000 fans. I mean, I know a lot of them were late because whatever happened, paper tickets or whatever reason, but they were loud. They were chanting all the way through. They was backing the team. And I loved the atmosphere. Lots of young people in the crowd, lots of big families. I wish that we could go and take 5, 6, 7 people with us every game. That would be amazing. But it was great to see a good turnout, and we're through to the next round, and it's home again. So hopefully we can get another big crowd like that against Leeds.
Yeah, home, and of course we're home on Sunday.
Yes.
Big North London derby. Yeah. What do you think? Do you think that game today had any bearing on that game? You know, Partey, of course, played a little while, about 60-odd minutes. So do you think that's anything on that, and what is your thoughts going into that big game on Sunday?
I think it gives a lot of players confidence going into that game, such as Partey. Saka, of course, he come on. I said he needed to come on for that game to warm up for Sunday. He's done exactly that. Had a few shots on goal. Contributed to Smith Rowe's goal, and I believe Eddie's as well. He was in that lead up to that goal. There's a lot of players in there that could be in contention for the game. Maybe we could see a Nuno come on at some point against Tottenham, because I think Nuno was outstanding today.
Yeah, he was fantastic today. I mean, his energy levels were unbelievable.
He was giving everything 100%. He started off at left back, ended up a left winger in the second half, creating chances, even got a header on goal, which I thought could have gone in, but the goalkeeper did quite well there. I think Sunday, it's always give or take, isn't it? You never know what's going to happen in North London derby. I feel like we're more likely to win, not just saying that as an Arsenal fan. But seeing Tottenham 2-0 up to Wolves at one point in the ground and seeing Wolves draw 2-2, I'm thinking, do you know what? There could be an upset here for Tottenham. And I was hoping it would happen, but I believe they've gone through on penalties. Yeah, they've gone through.
Unfortunately, they went through on penalties, yeah.
It happens. But I'm confident. 3-0 is a big result to go into a game on Sunday. good to see the youngsters get on today, get some goals. Eddie back in there getting goals. Yeah, happy for Lacazette. Hopefully he gets to feature in the North London Derby, because I know he loves the North London Derby.
He certainly does.
Yeah.
And we roll for Sunday.
Yes, roll.